We are in the town of Radabaugh, which is off of the Norfolk Southern Main Line. Basically Greensburg, Pennsylvania. Here we're seeing the Norfolk Southern local. He is dropping off cars for the Southwestern Pennsylvania SWP Railroad. That signal you see right there, that is called an APP marker. APP standing for approach. And that basically is just going to tell you that if he's going the other direction, that the next signal before it enters the main will be red. Now what he's doing is he is pulling through this siding track. You see the conductor waiting for him to clear. We'll take a quick look to see some of the trackage of the SWP, which at one time was once the Pennsylvania Railroad Southwest branch. Now it's not a big local today, and the conductor had lined the tracks, and he is doing a backup move. As an engineer, I can tell you some things about backing up. The first is the conductor has to be in a place where he can observe the movement. And if you look to the left, look closely, I know it's hard to see, but you would have seen that the conductor is in a place where he is watching and making sure that the track ahead is clear. Now he'll have a lot of room between where he's going to stop and his pickup. His pickup today is just simply two cars. Now those cars were dropped off by the SWP. So here we see he shoved his train onto that same track. Still plenty of room. This setup today is just going to be some gondolas and some covered hoppers. Being a licensed drone pilot, I'm able to show you some views that you may not get from the ground. It's always interesting for modeling to see what the inside of gondolas look like. Watching out for power wires right here. That was a close one. A lot of challenges as a drone operator. And never underestimate the power of banding. That is making sure that those loads do not shift. Now what's happening is he has stopped the conductor, which we see him walking. He is provided, I know at least with CSX, we call it three-step protection. That is whenever the reverser is centered, the independent brake is applied, and the generator field is down to prevent electricity going to the wheels. With that type of protection, he is able to go in between the equipment and put on handbrakes. Now, when you're switching cars in a yard, you don't have to put handbrakes every time you stop. But when you're leaving cars, yes, you do have to apply handbrakes. And we have what's known as a 1 minute brake test. We'll apply the brakes, or I'm sorry, he'll apply the handbrake, and then I'll release any braking on my end and make sure that that handbrake holds. It'll take 1 minute to do so. So here he left those cars there, and we're gonna see him just simply pull with light power. That's what we call it when there's just engines, we call it light power. And he is going to pull past the switch. Now one of the reasons why I'm doing this is just to show you how easy and simple a interchange works with another railroad. It's often neglected with model railroading. And here we see we got off the track, a little bit of editing just to show that he had already thrown the track to the opposite route, and a hand signal. We use hand signals whenever we're working just with engines. The engineer should be able to have a good line of sight to us. And so he gave the hand signal for a backup movement. He is riding that engine. The engineer is going to stay on the other engine until he ties on to the cars that were, those two cars that were left for him by the other railroad. And then he will, what we call change ends or switch engines, because he's eventually going to be heading back the direction that he came in from. I was glad to be able to catch this footage for you, because sometimes it's nice not always seeing wide bodies. Now, there are other ways of interchanging cars, and I do have other videos on my channel. I had to do a quick battery drone change and came back to see that he is now connected onto those cars. And we can see that the trackage down here was just very simple. The conductor is now rehanging the EOT, the end of train device. And people always ask me, well, what happened to the caboose? So the caboose is gone in most cases, and it's replaced by an electronic device. On the engine that we operate, and if you look up there, you can see that the engineer is now walking up to the other engine. He's going to go up, and on that engine, he'll be able to tell how much air is going through the train and onto that end of train device. The conductor at this point is removing the handbrakes. And in winter, it is challenging. It's not fun being a conductor in the winter. And that is simply how it's done. He did his brake test, make sure that the brakes applied and released. And now he's going to take his cars back to the yard. This is a local. That's why the power is going to be usually smaller. Now, I have a lot of other videos from this location, a lot about interchanging. And probably later on today, the SWP will come in with another set of cars and leave them and pick up these cars and head back to its industries. Simple. Now, I have a lot of other videos, so please subscribe to my channel, DJ's Trains, and you can also follow me on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. Interact with me one-on-one through Patreon. And at this time, I wanted to welcome my newest Patreon, John Barris. Thank you so much. And just a reminder that in this video's description, there's a lot of great links, so be sure to check out all the links. A lot of cool stuff. And I'll be seeing you guys in the next video. Cool stuff.